With some tricks in the free Snapseed app, I'm gonna try replicating neon lights in this image. Here I'm going to try the neon lights on signs in the middle and also this red roof on the gas station. To do that, first I need to turn them to white. First in tune image, increasing the saturation to the max, which helps in getting some contrast in the black and white filter. Opening the black and white filter, choosing the color where I'm gonna get maximum contrast on the signs. Selecting the yellow option here. You can notice the motel cafe sign has some grayish color. To make it completely black, I'm gonna use curves and tune the contrast to make it completely black. Now to make the remaining parts completely black, again with curves, dragging the top point to the bottom to make the image black, then going to the masking screen, tapping on the stacks icon, view edits, curves and brush. Here with the effect hidden and brush value at 100, I'm gonna zoom in and carefully brush around to make the surroundings black. Zooming out, brushing the remaining parts. I'll also manually brush around this board where I'm going to create neon light effect. Now I'm gonna save this. Next, I'm gonna go back to the original state by reverting back, which deletes all the effects applied. Next, using double exposure, I'm gonna add the saved image. And select subtract mode, which brings back the colors from the original image. Again, I'm gonna save this, which will be later needed. Reverting back again to the original state. Now starts the main process. First, I'm gonna make the image dark to get nearer to the night effect. In tune image, decreasing the brightness to the maximum. I'm gonna also decrease the saturation. Also making the image cooler by reducing the warmth. Making it a little more darker by reducing the brightness again. Next, I'm gonna add some red ambient light coming out of the board on the gas station. To do that, using curves, dragging the red curve up, which adds red to the overall image. Also lifting the RGB curve to make it a little brighter. Next, with masking, I'm gonna apply it there first by brushing it with 100% opacity and brushing out the remaining parts by reducing the brush transparency to 0. Also applying here on these with 25% transparency to make it look like some red light is falling there. Also a bit on the ground. Next, similarly to create on the Royce sign, first lifting the blacks, adding yellows by dragging the blue curve down, and a bit of greens too. With masking, applying it. Now creating some blues for the sign below. Adding blues and lifting blacks for brightness. Applying it with masking. Next, with double exposure tool, I'm going to add the last saved color text image and select the blend mode add, which switches on the neon lights. I'm going to now try to give some light to the signs on the right. Going back to the original image, I'm going to increase the temperature in white balance to 100 and save the image. Also delete this effect which is not needed here. Coming back to the previously lost edited state, using double exposure, I'm going to add the newly saved image and increase the opacity to 100. Then with masking, zooming in and brushing on the signs. This gives it a warm light effect. Also, I'm gonna apply it on the person in the middle. Board about two. Now I'm gonna add some green light effect in the gas station. Again with curves, adding greens and some brightness. With masking, applying it. Next, into an image, increasing brightness and warmth. With masking, applying it on some parts on the foreground. The colors on the person look too bright, so using selective filter, decreasing the saturation, also a little brightness. Applying some vignetting with the vintage filter, with masking, removing the effect on the parts where the lights were created. Going back to the first effect applied, where I'm going to bring back the saturation, which gives it a cooler look in the background. After these changes, the final result here. Thanks for watching.